Hi, welcome to our third video on linked lists. In this particular video, I'm going to do problem 2A from D.S. Malik's chapter 16 on linked lists. 2A is going to ask you to extend the linked list type class that Malik gives you by finding the deleted or the smallest node in the list. Now, what that means is if you were to sort these alphabetically or numerically, whatever, the smallest one is the first one. This will work as long as your object that you're node in your list has less than defined. The book wants us to add these as an abstract function in the linked list class. Abstract means if you define an abstract function in the parent class, then you must override that function in the child. So we're going to build this abstract function in the linked list class and do so in C++. Use the keyword called virtual. You just simply put virtual in front of the prototype, and that forces it to be abstract, and you as the developer have to implement it in a child class. Now, when you go to do this for your assignment, I'm going to strongly suggest doing one of two things. Either start a whole new exercise with these, or do like I've done and create a folder and copy my original items into it. So I have my original linked list, my original unordered list, my original ordered list there. The reason I did that is so that when I make a change in these things and it blows everything up, I can go back to what works. And you can do that right here in Visual Studio Code if you want. Simply select what you want, right-click copy, and right-click paste. And they'll be in your original items. All right, so let's take a look at my finished version. I've got a numeric list here. I chose numbers because it's really easy to visualize smallest numbers. So I've got a linked list, an unordered linked list, with -2 as my smallest value in there. I print before and after I delete. Did it again, parenthesis again. So before I delete, -2 is right here. After delete, you see -2 is gone. So let's make this happen. So I need a new C++. Oh, it's helping me again. So I'll build my basic class. I'm going to take some of the code for my done one just to save some time. I need these two pound includes, and I need this unordered list. Doesn't matter how big or how small your list is, just create a list. And then I'll need this proof. I'm going to comment out delete smallest because I'm not there yet. I'll do a quick run, make sure I didn't do anything stupid. All right, cool. Everything's working. Okay, so I'm ready to go. I've got my main program set up. I'm now ready to do the hard part, and this stuff is going to be pretty hard. So what I need to do is I need to start in linked list.h. I'm going to close this for a while. All of these linked list files start with your struct, which if you watch the very first video that I presented to you, it has a data type of info and then a pointer to it. And then it defines how this struct works. I'm going to scroll past that until you find your linked list type, roughly line 102. But look for class linked list type. And inside of the public section, we'll have all of our methods. We see here a virtual bool search is in here. Find somewhere where it makes sense to put this in. I'm going to put it here down before the protected section. And I'm also going to comment here. So I know it was added. That way, if you know, we come back and you know this thing really blows up, I know how to yell at. So I'm going to add my prototype. the virtual again says, hey, you need to override this in your child class. Now, as soon as I say that, everything else is going to break. Because all these other classes here, ordered linked list and unordered linked list, depend upon delete smallest. That's why I suggested creating another folder. So now I need to modify unordered list. And this one's a little simpler to set up. The class unordered linked list is right there. And you see how it inherits off of linked list. And it takes the type passed in, which is pretty cool, actually. And then in here, all of our methods. Add it somewhere. I'm going to add it here to the bottom. So there's the prototype, and again, comment that you added it. You could comment what it does. Now, this is one of those things you don't need to comment because I named it well, delete smallest. But you can see Malik did a very nice job of commenting all of his code. So I'm going to add delete smallest. I'm going to add it all the way to the bottom, just because I want it there. So I need to define my template class type. You see how it's done in each one of these? Or temp outs. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but thunder and lightning here. Okay, so what this thing's going to have to do is it's going to have to walk through the list and find the smallest value. Now, I need a bunch of variables to set this up. No type is the struct. Current is the current item in the list I'm walking through. Trail current is where I'm at in my list. Small is the guy that I found that's the smallest. And trail small is where it is in the list. Now, we're going to start by saying, hey, if the list is not empty, then go on. If the list is empty, die. Now, I don't particularly care to see out inside these classes, but the author does, so I'm going to stick with his setup. Then again, I'm sticking with the author thought process there. So this is just my idiot check. So now I'm going to find the smallest. Now, the idea of finding the smallest is you start with the first value. And you say, hey, maybe the first value is the smallest, because you know, it could be. And you set that small variable equal to the first guy in the list. And then you start walking through the list until you get the end. You compare what you think is the smallest to the current item. If the current item is smaller than what you think is smallest, you swap it. It's your basic min code, but done inside of a linked list. So make small be first. And start at the beginning of the list. Now I love this structure. pull out the link from the first node. So the current pointer is the link from the first node. That's really cool. I'm now going to traverse or walk through the list. And they're always set the same way. It's a while loop. Again, if you watch that YouTube video that I added to the list, you know that the list ends when it comes to a null pointer. List can be a billion things long. The last guy points to null. So keep looping while current's not equal to null. And now you do your basic min logic. Basically, what we've just determined there. If the info in the smallest node, that we think is the smallest node, is bigger than the current node, then we clearly don't know what the smallest is. So we'll make the smallest node the current. So now, by the time we get through this list, we'll know what the smallest value in the list is. Alright, so trail current equal current equal current link. Again, this is holding on to current. And when I say currents equal current arrow link, this basically says because my current pointer, the link reaches out to the next guy on the list. Since this is pretty long, definitely comment at the end of your whiles. Now, we're also going to check to see if the smallest guy is the first element in the list. Because we have some special ways to handle deleting from the first element in the list. The list needs to know where the first element of the list is, called first. It needs to know that because that's where C++ will go into memory to start the chain. If we lose first, we lose the entire memory structure. So that's why we're checking to see if the smallest guy is the first guy. So what this is saying, when I get this structure right, so if the first item in the list is the smallest one in the list, then I simply say, hey, overwrite the first item in the list with the length from the first item in the list. So basically make the first item the second. Otherwise, I'm going to override what is the current small one. Again, really helpful comment at the end of these things, because they're getting complicated. So at this point, once we get here, we're going to get rid of our small pointer and decrease count by one. Let's see if I did this right. Come back here. No longer yells at me, so least smallest is built. Look at that, it's gone. So what you learned here is you learn how to read this linked list file. You learn how to traverse through the list, which is this while loop, to find whatever it is you're looking for, smallest, biggest, medium, whatever. And then you learn how to manipulate some of the lists. Many of the assignments in this week's exercises depend upon this structure. Now, going forward, all you can really know how to do is how to build linked lists. You know, I don't think that it's extremely helpful for you to learn how to edit these files, especially not at your stage of programming. What is important is you learn how to implement linked lists. So if you get that, you're good. And we're going to do it better in our next videos. Okay, so now that we have this working here, you could copy and paste this code over to ordered linked list to make it set up. But I'll let you guys do that. All right, you know everything you need to know to build your assignments this week. So good luck.